Hey Dell fans, welcome back to our exclusive CES preview. We're here in New York City giving you the first look at all of the AI PCs as well as the other components of that ecosystem, which includes Dell's AI Pro Studio, which I'm very excited to talk to Marc about. Marc, thank you so much for hanging out this morning.
Thanks for being here.
What is the studio? This is fairly brand new. People are getting excited. Break it down.
Yeah, absolutely. So, as you know, it's been a fantastic year for AI, especially for the AI PC. It's kind of the new kid on the block, right? Through the years, we've had IHVs out there with great CPU, GPU performance, but now there's a new component, a new player, the neural processing unit, right? The really interesting thing is there's a lot of differentiation out there when it comes to the NPU, but that adds complexity. Complexity in tool chains, complexity in software frameworks, complexity in knowing, hey, is this thing going to perform? So we're trying to solve for that for our customers. And the way that we're doing that is through the Dell Pro AI Studio. And it's a great piece of software that's going to layer on top and simplify things for developers. We're talking about taking it from a 6-month lead time when you're just bootstrapping down to about 6 weeks. It's a pretty phenomenal game.
Whoa, so how exactly do you see that, what feels like an order of magnitude time decrease?
Yeah, absolutely. So when you think about it, it's a complex problem. Not only are you dealing with the silicon complexity that's out there, you're dealing with model complexity. What models run best on these machines? Which ones are going to solve the problems that I want to solve? And so what we're doing is we're going to take a 3-pronged approach to that. We're going to go through the Dell Enterprise Hub, and we're going to curate AI models for AI PCs out there, along with a set of Dell validated designs for AI PCs. So you'll have models out there that you will know will work well on those systems, highly performant, great accuracy, and reference code to go and use as you bootstrap yourself on the
machine. I got to dive in there just for a second, because I think that's so important. Yeah. There are thousands, tens of thousands, over 100,000 different models that people can choose from. And I think when companies or individuals are getting started in AI, it can be a bit overwhelming to understand what tools, what models, what devices are going to be best for whatever solution they're trying to come up with. So what is that process like in curating that choose your own adventure for the Dell AI Studio user?
Yeah, absolutely. We'll bring them down. We'll take a look. We'll build some reference code around them, kind of kick the tires and figure out what works well for some of the use cases that we know people want to stand up. Chatbots, RAG-based models that are local. We're talking no network required, right? Maybe you're trying to do super resolution. Maybe you're doing image search. We'll do the hunting and pecking and build those things out for you and make them available as part of Dell Pro AI Studio.
What are some of the other use cases that you're excited about?
Yeah, you know, it's one that we talk about. I love kind of the agentic theme that's coming up, right? And I love that you can imagine like you walking in and there's kind of that customer you're going to go on the monthly visit to, and maybe they have that hot button issue. And you walk in the door and they're like, hey, you know what? Scrap today's agenda. I'm going to talk about this. You need to be ready in 15 minutes. What are you going to do? You can imagine that you had all your collateral right there on the system and you could feed it into an agent and say, hey, look, we've got this issue. We're gonna have to figure out a solution. Let me know what we could do. And right there immediately, without having network connectivity, it can craft a response to help drive that conversation with your customer. So there's those types of scenarios that are like really, really real world for many people that an AI PC could solve.
So it's like having the smartest kid in the room as your study buddy, but it can compute anything in 5 minutes.
Yeah, exactly.
And you don't get called out for cheating.
That's right. Never gets tired. Always on. Always ready for you. It's making those lists. It's thinking ahead. That's exactly the experience we want our customers to have.
I love that. So one of the themes, and Michael talked about this a lot in his keynote today, was the magic that happens.
Yeah.
And tell me if you think this analogy makes sense. When I think about the devices, they're kind of like the wand, the physical thing that's going to bring that magic. And then the dust, the fairy dust a bit, is this AI studio.
Yeah, absolutely.
Do you think that's accurate?
Yeah, I think there's a lot of magic to it.
Yeah.
It's a lot of hard work under the hood. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It does take a lot to get there. But that's the intent. We want it to be a seamless experience. We want it to be easy for customers. We want it to solve very real pain points for them. And we think Dell Pro AI Studio can do that.
How long have you been working on the studio? I can imagine the hardware and the studio have been together in conjunction for a while.
Yeah. I would say that we've been working on this for the better part of a year, maybe a little bit longer. It's been a long road. Really happy to see it come to fruition. I think we talked earlier about, hey, it's a lot like Christmas. You know, it's that time of the year, so it has that feeling as well.
Yes, it does. And congratulations to you and the team. How exactly does it work? So let's say I'm a developer, very excited by this conversation, which I'm hoping many are. How do I get started?
Yeah, sure. Again, we would start with Dell Enterprise Hub. Go look out there, models, reference code, think about your problem set. Then there's the runtime piece, the piece that actually runs down on the client device. We'll provide that. That will be the execution engine, and that will leverage any number of runtimes that are out there, some of the open ones, some of the proprietary ones. So you can kind of pick, hey, do I want to go broad with my solution, or do I want to get into a really high performance scenario? Up to the developer to choose. And then the third part is the management of that. We really don't talk about that much, but you can imagine that, hey, models drift over time. Model accuracy can wane over time. New versions of models become available, and you might want to deploy one of those. So there's a management aspect to Dell Pro AI Studio through the Dell management portal, and you'll be able to deploy those models and manage them on the client devices that are in your fleet.
That's pretty cool. You mentioned model lifespan being about 90 days.
Yeah, it's been remarkable. If you think about it, models make news these days, which is just crazy, right? But it's true.
Yes.
I mean, there are improvements in performance, improvements in accuracy. And so the lifetime of a model, yeah, it's probably about 3 months. And that could just be a version improvement in the same model family, or it could be a completely new model that shows up on the horizon.
I've got just a couple more questions for you. One, do you think that 2025 is the year of agentic AI?
I think that it'll be the start to it, for sure. We'll start to see things on the horizon, and that's a really exciting space, especially when you're talking AI PCs, because I think it's easy to imagine agents in the cloud, but then you get to play around with, okay, a little thought experiment on what could an AI agent do to help you, right? Drafting emails, looking at predictive actions, maybe taking care of your laptop while you're away, applying patches, things like that to keep it up to date. All of those things are possible with agentic AI.
I agree with you there, for what it's worth. I think we're going to see some interesting things happen in that space. I know that Mark Benioff and Michael are friends, and Mark's committed to 1 billion AI agents this coming year. So we'll see what happens with those million agents, or million. I don't know if I said 1 billion. Sorry, fam, if I did. Question for you. So we're talking, it's January. What do you hope to be able to say at Dell Tech World in May that we can't quite yet say today, now that more of this is going to be out in the wild?
I think that, I definitely think it's going to be the year of the AI PC. You're going to see a lot more. One of the great things about Dell is we have a great end-to-end story, and that's the power of the Dell AI factory. I would say watch out for that come May. There'll be some really interesting things to see.
That's very exciting. We were there when you launched your AI factory last year at Dell Tech World. Actually, my nails are inspired by the Dell Tech AI factory, if you go check it out, as a matter of fact, because I thought it was so cool. And so we can't wait to see that. All right, last question for you. Speaking as a human, not just as a Dell Tech employee, what excites you the most about what's possible, both with the AI PC, but also with AI in general?
You know, it's had this amazing leveling effect. Things that I couldn't do before. You know, there's that whole theory around like a requisite 10,000 hours to become an expert in anything. Now with AI, suddenly there's an expert at your disposal. And when you take that and you apply the creative forces that we all have, suddenly you can do all kinds of things that you've never been able to do before. And I think that's amazing. That's going to be just such a game changer for all kinds of entrepreneurs around the world. Suddenly they've got access to talent they wouldn't have had access to before.
Oh, I think you're absolutely right. Actually, just triggered one more question.
Yeah, sure.
So I'm curious, because I got made fun of for this over the holidays for my own mother. When you're communicating with an AI, whether that be Copilot or ChatGPT or Gemini, or playing with anything really, are you polite and kind, or are you direct and linear in your asks?
I'm polite and kind. It's just odd to me to just be direct and linear in the ask. And I think I think if we develop AI in the right way, you'll want that kind of an experience, and it could actually add value to it overall.
Yeah, I'm with you. I'm super polite to all the devices. And my mother was absolutely grilling me for being too nice to technology. And I said, you know, first of all, we don't know what happens next. Also, I can't help but be kind. I don't know how
to... Are
you
worried about who's going to be in charge?
Yeah. Let's just say I'm cognizant of the potential capacity. I wouldn't say that it's a fear. And I'm nice to the machines, so I'm hoping that they're going to be nice to me.
Absolutely.
But
start early.
Yeah.
I love it.
Well, thank you so much, Marc. I really appreciate you taking the time this morning. And I'm so excited to see what people create with the Dell AI Studio. It's going to be really impressive.
Appreciate that. Thanks, Savannah.
Cheers. And thank all of you for tuning in for this super awesome CES 2025 preview. We're here in Manhattan and in Las Vegas this week. Let us know what you think the coolest thing you could develop in the AI Studio is in the comments. My name's Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.